I opened something I shouldn't have. Now what? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question I got. I have a question. I recently downloaded a wrong file after being redirected. I even allowed the .exe to run this command. I didn't see it type anything before closing it though. After allowing the threat in Windows Security, I did a full scan afterwards and it said everything was fine. Should I be worried and consider a factory reset? Wow. Worried? Probably. This is exactly the scenario that security folks warn against so strenuously. Running or opening something you shouldn't have, and even bypassing warnings from your security software. Let's take a look at your options. Now, of course, the pedantic answer, the only answer, is that if what you ran could be malware, then there's really only one answer: factory reset. Okay, there's another, I'll call it a pedantic answer, which I'll talk about later. But the bottom line here is that if you find yourself in this situation, the only way to be guaranteed that the malware or potential malware is gone is to back up your machine completely, so that things can carefully be recovered later if needed, and then reinstall Windows from scratch. Yeah, it's brutal. The problem is that once you allow it to run on your machine, malware can do anything, even hiding itself in such a way that your security software might not see it. In a very real sense, once malware is on your machine, it's not your machine anymore. The only way to be completely positive, 100% certain that the malware, if indeed it was malware, is removed, is to erase everything and reinstall. Now, to be clear, that answer is what most would call the one true answer. Some would say it's the only answer. When in doubt, that's what you should do. However, depending on what you know about what was run and the amount of risk you're willing to take, we might be able to start with something a little less daunting. An important consideration is just where did the download come from? If it's from a site that you know or at least recognize, well, that's less risky than what the original questioner experienced being redirected to a URL you've never heard of. The same thinking applies to an email detachment. If you are certain that you know and trust the sender, well, that's less risky than having opened an attachment from someone you've never heard from before. If, when downloading something, or if you run that something, your security software complains, well, yeah, that's usually a bad sign. I say usually because the specific wording of the complaint matters when assessing risk. For example, Windows Defender Smart Screen might get in the way of a download because it doesn't recognize the application or its digital signature. That doesn't necessarily mean the application is malware, and it's something we sometimes have to legitimately bypass when downloading something we know is safe. In situations like this, it's a data point. However, if your security software tells you something along the lines of, hey, this is malware, and you bypass that warning anyway, well, that's a clear sign that there's something amiss. To be clear, the risk is never zero. But if the risk seems low, perhaps you know where the download came from and your security software said nothing or something amounting to a simple warning, then you might consider sidestepping the nuclear option. That looks like this. Run a full scan, not a quick scan if that's an option, with your existing security software of all the drives connected to your system when the questionable program was run. Then, download a second security package. The free version of Malwarebytes is what I recommend as a good number two, and run full scans with it as well. If both come up clean, then proceed with caution. Keep an eye out for unexpected behavior, but you might have dodged a bullet. Now, if either comes up with malware being detected, then what happens next depends on that tool's ability to remove and/or quarantine the malware. If it's successfully dealt with, again, you may have dodged a bullet. If the scans have difficulty removing the malware, then the nuclear option may be your only path to recovery. And after all this, if this is causing you the least bit of concern, Then, that reset might still be worth the effort anyway. Back up your machine first to preserve data, and a reinstall, it'll help you sleep at night. Now, I want to make sure, before we move on, that we also understand that we need to learn from this experience. I also want to be clear that there's no shame here. We've all made these kinds of mistakes at least once. I know I have. So let's focus on making sure that it remains once. Based on the description, I would encourage you to A, slow down. The story sounds like you were in a hurry to get whatever was promised. That, as you've now seen, is a recipe for making mistakes. B, pay attention to the URL, particularly if it's redirected to something you've never seen before. Your browser's address bar is an incredibly important resource, not just for telling your browser where to go, but also seeing where exactly you've been taken. Don't run. Obviously, the whole idea of most legitimate downloads is that you would run them. My advice here boils down to another variation of slow down. Once the file is downloaded, take a breath and think about whether you really, truly believe this download is safe. If you're not sure, don't run it. D, listen to your security software. If it pops up, there's a reason. It's not something to panic over, but it is something to read and understand before you proceed. All right, I mentioned that there was a second pedantic answer. You can avoid a factory reset completely by doing one thing: restoring your machine to the most recent full image backup taken prior to your having downloaded and run the questionable software. It's the ultimate undo. It restores your machine to the state it was in before anything happened, all without spending hours reinstalling and recovering everything. The catch? Well, you need to be backing up regularly. Specifically, you need to be taking full image backups regularly. I recommend a process that gets you daily snapshots. Above all, of course, be careful. Yeah, you now have a plan for what to do when you suspect malware may have reached your machine, but please resolve never to need it. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/185401. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.